SolidWorks makes it really easy to leverage, reuse, and change existing models or imported 3D geometry. When we take a look at this telephone base, we see that it's featureless, just a dumb solid, and we need to make some changes. Let's see how we can manipulate the face topology in the bodies to modify the design. Notice that we have a direct editing toolbar where we have the common commands that are used to manipulate this geometry. Let's start by using the delete face tool. And I can simply window around my faces of interest. And you notice in the property manager that we have a number of options here. Do we just want to delete the faces or patch it by extending the surrounding geometry? And I think that's the one for us. And notice that those faces have deleted as if they were never there. We can use this again to take care of this unintended notch in this rib. We'll use the delete face tool, pick our faces of interest, and tell SolidWorks to extend the surrounding faces to patch it all up. That looks great, and you notice we're still working with a solid body. SolidWorks gives us some incredible flexibility as well, and it understands design intent. For example, if I wanted to modify this clip, I could use the Move Face tool, pick my faces of interest, tell SolidWorks to translate them, and now I can move those faces in the XYZ direction. But in my case, I simply want to make it taller. I think it is so cool that we get this scale that pops up that lets me manipulate the offset or the translation value with accuracy and precision. There's my new clip. And of course, I get a parametric dimension that I can manipulate as well to change it in the future if I so desire. It's pretty easy to duplicate existing geometry features like the ones we just created because our pattern features are aware of faces. So if I go and select the faces that I'm interested in, all these faces for this particular component, get my faces of interest. And now I can ask SolidWorks to pattern these guys in a specific linear direction and even make them symmetrical as desired. And of course, I get a parametric dimension here. And if I ever wanted to make a change to it, I have the option of doing so. For more dramatic changes, I can use our split tool to break away this boss as a separate body. I'll cut the part, and I'll ask SolidWorks to simply break out that boss as a separate body. And now I can use a very common tool, the Move Copy Body command, grab that body, and again, using parametric tools, move it around as needed, and create a boss there as well. Finally, if I like what I've done, and all of these parametric features and modifications that I've created, it would make sense to combine them all, these bodies back together into a single cohesive solid body. And there we have modifying an imported part using common commands in SolidWorks.